Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today, I'm just gonna drop off some trading tips for beginners that I used to get my wreath necklace. Some of these tips might not help you if you've already been trading for a while. This is genuinely for new people, returning people, and that's pretty much it if I'm being so for real. These tips have helped other people when I told them, and so I figured I'd make it into a video and try to help other people. But if you disagree with these or they don't work out as good for you as they did for me, that's a tragedy. Don't comment it. I will start crying. So I want to start out with probably the biggest thing that I can tell y'all, the biggest tip or the most helpful tip that I can think of that helped me a lot. I'm gonna go more in depth in this later, but just the basics of it are if something has like a range of what it's worth, like let's say 4 to 5 den betas, you would only want to trade 4 den betas for it. You wouldn't want to trade 5. And that's pretty common knowledge. But let's say, for instance, somebody was trading you this item for a bigger item. So your item's worth like 10 den betas, and somebody's trading you something worth 4 to 5. Count that as 4. But if you were in the other person's position where you were trading this item that's worth 4 or 5 den betas for an item that's worth 10, you want to count your item as 5 den betas. So if you're trading for something, you want to count it at the lowest possible value. And if you're trading it off to somebody, you want to count it as the highest possible value. And that'll help out with a lot of different items, even large variety. If you're just starting out and you don't have any items to trade with yet, and you're a member, just farm the Forgotten Desert for den betas, clothing betas, and stuff like that. You can't get collars from it anymore, but you can get spiked wrists. So just farm the Forgotten Desert for a little bit until you have enough items to start out with. And if you're a non-member, just do Return of the Phantoms on hard mode because you can get clothing betas and stuff from it. And if you play with 4 accounts, so 3 alts, you can get extra prizes. So if your computer can handle it, I would definitely bring alts along. Den betas are pretty simple. All you need to know is member den betas are considered 1 den beta, and non-member den betas are worth 1.5 or 2 den betas. The non-member den betas can be worth up to twice as much as a member den beta. So be careful when you're trading a mix of member and non-member den betas. Also, stay away from walls or floors. You'll see a lot of people asking for den betas and then follow that up with no WOF. WOF stands for walls or floors. Nobody likes them. Don't trade for them. Don't trade them. Stay away from them if at all possible. Also, Amy's frogs, according to the Worth Wiki, are worth a bad short collar. No, they are not. They're absolutely not. Count those as a red long wrist at most. And the claw machine is worth, I think it said like 2 other den betas. Just consider that a yellow long wrist or maybe a pink long wrist if you're lucky. So if you see somebody asking for den betas for their red short collar, which is worth 7 den betas, never in your life should you trade them 7 non-member den betas. Because at the minimum, that's worth 11.5, and at the most, that's worth 14 den betas. Never trade purely non-member den betas if you're giving the amount that it's listed for. So as long as you can do basic math and count non-member den betas as 1.5 or 2 den betas, you're gonna be fine. Don't worry about den betas. They're super easy and a lot of people like them, so they're always gonna be easy to trade off. And another good thing about den betas that I forgot to mention once again is if somebody trades you an item worth a den beta? No, it's not. It's not worth a den beta. Pretend like it's not. So, for instance, like Jamalade bows and Cupid wings, non-glossy Cupid wings. The wiki says they're worth a den beta. Nuh-uh. No, they are not. Don't count those. Pretend like they're not there. So, yeah. If you have an option, just go for den betas. Don't go for items worth den betas. It's gonna be a headache. Trust me on that one. Just don't take it. Short wrists are pretty mid in general, but a general rule of thumb is if it's blue or lower, so orange, green, yellow, or pink, or blue, just consider those 1 member den beta. If it's a purple or a red short wrist, count that as a non-member den beta. If it's a black short wrist, count it as two member den betas. That doesn't mean you should trade den betas for short spikes, or short wrists, I should say, but if you have them, that's what you should be looking for them. And if you are trading these wrists for something else, that's what you need to count them as. But don't trade your den betas for these wrists, because den betas are easier to trade off than short wrists. So if you have short wrists, try to get den betas for them. But if you have den betas, don't try to get short wrists for them. Something I forgot to mention about den betas is a lot of people will try to trade you fake den betas. So make sure you check the Worth Wiki and know what real den betas look like. One big one is the bubblegum machine. There's a beta bubblegum machine and one that was released in parties, and I have them up on screen so you can see the difference. But make sure you don't take fake bubblegum machines, because there are slimy people who are going to try to take advantage of you. Moving on to long wristbands. Anything below blue is just worth two member den betas. That's what you're going to be able to get out of them, and that's all you should really expect from them. Blue, not the best, but you can get a non-member and a member den beta for it. For purple, you can get two non-member, and for red, you can also usually get two non-member or three member. For purple long wrists, I usually trade two member for them and then count them as three when I'm trading up. So just kind of experiment a little, but long wrists, typically I wouldn't try to trade down for den betas. I would just try to trade them up for good collars, or good short collars, I should say. For short collars below pink, they're generally just cheeks. So orange, green, and yellow, I wouldn't go for. But if that's what you've got, that's fine. You can still work with it. For orange and green, I would do no trade other than two non-member den betas. Somebody's going to be desperate enough to take that, but you can do two non-member or three member den betas for that, and it's the same value either way. But I would not give more than three den betas worth for an orange or a green short collar. For yellow, I might stretch it to four, but you can probably get it for 3.5 if we're being honest. So just lowball pretty hard when it comes to bad short collars, because they're bad for a reason. Nobody really likes them. Pink shorts, even though they're below blue on the Worth Wiki, are worth more in my opinion. So if you're trading up den betas or wrists, I would never go for a blue short collar. I would never trade up to a blue short collar. In general, people don't like blue spikes. So if you can stay away from those colors or that color, then you're better off doing that. So if you're trading up for a pink, they're worth 5 on the wiki. You can get them for 4. I promise you can get them for 4. Blues, just stay away from. Don't let people trade you blue shorts or any blue spikes. If it's a good deal, it's a good deal, but typically if there's a blue collar in it or a blue spike, it's not a good deal. And going off what I just said about blue not being good, the wiki considers blue, purple, and red to be the three good colors. Blue is not really a good color. Nobody wants to take blue shorts, so don't consider blue good. Consider it decent at best, because again, nobody likes that color. I don't know why, that's just how the game goes, but stay away from it. Purple and red shorts, you can get 7 den betas for it. That's an accurate one on the wiki. They're right about that worth. But me personally, I've gotten pretty good trades where I gave 3 non-member den betas for a red short. So, and that's worth 4.5. So there's always wiggle room, and people will always take non-member den betas, even if it's not a lot of them. And if you have short collars that I would say are pink or better, I would not trade them down for wristbands. I would just go straight for den betas for them. Because according to the wiki, a red short is worth 2 good long wristbands. So even if you got 2 red long wristbands for your red short, you're still missing out on a den beta that you could have gotten if you just traded the red short down by itself. So I would stay away from trading down to wrists. But if you have wrists, feel free to trade them up. Obviously, that's kind of the goal. Moving on to long collars. The biggest thing I need to say is if you can be patient with trading, Never take purely den betas for your long collars. It's always better to trade them down for short collars and wrists and then trade them down for den betas than just taking den betas pure for it. So, for instance, an orange long collar is worth 10 den betas, but it's also worth two good short collars. And if you get two good short collars, you can trade each one of those down for 7 den betas and make 4 more den betas than you would have if you just traded down the orange long collar for den betas. But if you're starting out with den betas and you can afford to trade 10 for an orange long or a green long, that's a good idea. Just don't take den betas for your long, but you can give den betas for other people's longs, because then you can just trade them down to shorts and wrists and trade them into more den betas. And that's an easy way to just repeatedly get profit little by little, and that'll get you pretty far. So if you can be patient, that's what I would recommend. But if you're impatient and just want a lot of trades really fast, then taking den betas for your longs isn't the worst thing you can do. It's still fair, but it's better if you can be patient and trade them down for other collars and stuff like that. Another good thing to mention is even though pink longs are lower than blue longs, people will trade blue longs and a small add, like a couple of rims, for a pink long. So don't let anybody tell you that blue is better than pink. Again, blue demand is just really low for whatever reason. I don't understand it, but that's just the way it is. So go for pink. Pink is actually really high demand, so you can get more out of it than even what the wiki tells you. Yellow longs are pretty mid, and there's nothing really to say about them. Their demand is all right, and you can trade them off pretty easily, but I wouldn't recommend trying to trade them down. I would just use them to trade up to solids. So yellow longs are worth a bad long collar and a good long wrist. So if you really want to do a trade like that, you can. But me personally, if I were to trade it down, I would probably just go for a bad long collar and den betas instead of the wrist. Purple longs are all right. I typically just use them to trade up to solids, but if that's all you've got right now and you need to trade it down, the wiki says it's worth a bad long collar and a black short collar. I would not do that trade just because I don't like black short collars. But if you do get that, then you can use the black short collar and one den beta and get an orange long out of it if you're lucky. So I wouldn't do that. I would prefer something like a bad long collar, a good short collar, and I don't know, maybe a bad short collar or a decent short collar, something like that, instead of a black short. But if that's the trade you get and you have some den betas laying around that you can trade up with to get an orange long, then I don't have a problem with it and you should be fine. For red long collars, really the only trade you should take if you're trading it down is an orange long collar and a green long collar. Or if you want to skip long collars and somebody offers you four good short collars, so purple and red, you can take that too. That just skips a step of trading down the bad long collars. Those are two good options. But apart from that, if you're trading down a red long, I wouldn't take any other offers. As for solids, a lot of people are going to try to trade you a red long and a purple long for yours, and that's not a good trade. But if you have a red long and a purple long collar, you can absolutely get a solid for that, and that's your ideal trade if that's what you've got. A lot of people might decline you at first, but you're gonna find somebody who's willing to take it, and some people even specifically request that for their solid. So you can get it for that deal, but if you're the one with a solid, do not take a red long and a purple long. You've got to have at least a good long wrist added on to that trade, but do not just take a red long and a purple long for it. Another offer people will try to give you for solids is three decent long collars, so pink and yellow. I would try to stray away from that offer if it's all three longs are yellow, but if it's like two yellows and a pink, then that's decent enough where I would take it. But I wouldn't do three decents if they're all yellow. And another one is four bad longs. I wouldn't do that if it wasn't orange and green, or two oranges and two greens, I mean, for your solid. I wouldn't take four oranges. I might take three oranges and a green, but ideally you would get at least two greens if you were trading your solid down to bad long collars. And I'm pretty sure that's all there is to mention about spikes. They're pretty easy as long as you don't do dumb trades and take bad spikes like any blue spike. But as long as you don't trade them down for den betas, specifically den like only den betas, then it's kind of hard to lose with spikes. But if you have den betas, you can trade them up for long collars. Like some people will take 20 den betas for a red long. That's pretty good because if you trade those down to good shorts, you can get 28 out of it. So you can do trades like that. And again, if you're impatient, you can take trades for den betas for your spikes. But if you're really just trying to get the most profit and like be a laid back trader, then I would just recommend trading down to spikes, to lower spikes, and then to den betas instead of directly to den betas. But that's another option you can go with if you don't feel like waiting. And with variety, I would just kind of try to stay away from variety if I'm being for real. Until you're good at trading and know demand of a lot of items, I would just stick away from it because I lost a lot of value from doing variety trades like tiki masks, party hats, a lavender bunny hat, which is horrible. The main problem with that is the wiki tells you what it's worth, but doesn't tell you the demand. So if the demand is really low, you're probably not gonna get what the wiki says it's worth. So stay away from variety, especially small variety like skunk tails or trick or treat buckets is another one. I can't think of any other like real small variety, but I would stay away from variety worth less than a solid unless you just want the item or you're collecting them. Then of course it's fine to go for them, but if you plan on trading them off and trying to make a profit, I would do my best to stay away from variety, and I wouldn't take trades with variety of items that I don't know the worth and demand of, because I did that a few times and I lost a good bit of worth. So in general, just stay away from variety until you know a lot more about trading. Yeah, so that's it for this video. Thank you for watching. If the tips helped you at all, leave a comment saying they did. If you have any questions, also feel free to leave a comment. I'll answer them for everybody, or DM me if you don't feel like making a comment. But yeah, if they helped you out, like, comment, subscribe. I'm trying to get to 350 by the end of May. So if you can help me out with that, would be greatly appreciated. And yeah, thanks for watching. I'll see y'all in the next one. Bye.